Hi, I'm Peter from uventer, and in this video I will show you how to set up underwater sundries with fake caustics. First, create a landscape object with a slight amount of furrows. Also, deactivate borders at sea level. Next, create a spotlight, parent it under a null object and position it. Create a disk, set it to negative Z and parent it under your light source. Move it a little bit forward, because this will act as a shadow object. Create a uRender material, deactivate color and reflectance, and activate the mask channel. Assign a noise and a texture channel, and activate animated and set the resolution to high. To get shapes that would fit for an underwater scene, I try to see my noise and adjust the values. Also invert the colors. Don't forget to set the animation speed value higher than 0, otherwise we won't see any kind of animation. Also, increase the preview resolutions for the live mode in the render settings. Now create a volume object and increase the density of media E. The sharpness or detail of the sun rays depends on the sample radius of the shadows. Just increase it if you want to have the sun rays smoother. The shadow resolution has not much impact on the quality, so you can keep a lower resolution. Also create a uRender camera and adjust the clipping plane values. This increases the resolution grid of the voxels that are used for the volumetrics. If this is roughly set up, you can set the background color in the render settings, or use the simple fog. First adjust the density and then adjust the background strength, so that the border of your landscape geometry disappears. To have more control for the color of the rays and the color of the fake caustics, you only need to duplicate your light source and then deactivate the values you don't need. With this setup, you can now change the colors independently. In the render settings, use the filter curves to increase the contrast of your image. In the volumetrics tab, you can adjust the density of the voxel grid for the volumetrics. Just set the Z resolution twice as high as the resolution in X and Y to get a uniform result. The subdivision slider works as a multiplier, and it is super helpful to adjust the quality performance very quickly. Now it's time to fill the scene with objects, textures and so on, but this is something I will leave to you. I hope you like this workflow. Thanks for watching.